Let's talk a little bit about artificial intelligence. You've probably heard the term, but do you want to invest in it, and is it really good for the world? Jay Jacobs, Vice President and Head of Research at Global X Funds, is here to talk about this in particular, this particular topic. You know, Stephen Hawking, Jay, had said that this was the biggest threat to humanity, that if we don't control AI in its current state, that we could be going down a very frightening path. What do you make of those comments?
So if you really look at the extended comments of Stephen Hawking, what he's saying is this is a transformational technology, and it's really at an inflection point. And when you look at any transformational technology, you can use it for good and you can use it for bad. And I think what we really like to focus on is the good that AI is going to do. It's actually incredibly proficient at diagnosing diseases, at improving things like traffic patterns, at automating repetitive tasks in people's jobs. That's a huge positive for the world, and I think can really, be a good benefit to society as a whole.
But, you know, there's this other side of this, and this is part of why, you know, Donald Trump was elected president. The threat to manufacturing, the threat to the American worker with robotics taking over the manufacturing process, whether it's cars, whether it's widgets, whether it's Amazon's warehouses. I mean, what about that threat to the economy?
So when you see really some of the complaints among workers is that they feel very disengaged right now, that they're being assigned tasks that are not stimulating, not creative. And what we're going to see is robotics is really going to take on those tasks first, which means that's leaving the more creative, more interesting, more stimulating jobs for people. And I think that's going to really raise the overall engagement of employees around the world. And that's going to be a positive again. A lot of jobs, a lot of tasks that we do in our everyday are frankly kind of boring and somewhat beneath us. And I think that's the kind of stuff that we'd love to pass off to AI so we can focus on the more interesting aspects.
Okay. So what's the investment play here?
So right now, artificial intelligence as a pure play, the way that we look at it in our ETF is looking at some hardware manufacturers that are building the chips that are enabling AI. So specifically looking at GPUs, graphic processing units, these are the brains behind AI. They're very sophisticated chips that can handle hundreds, if not thousands, of inputs at once. That's really our kind of laser focus right now for AI, but it could expand in the future as more companies get into the space.
You also like, and I'm assuming we'll leave it at chip makers. I'm assuming you're talking about the Qualcomms, the SanDisks of the world. But let's move to really quick to lithium, because you say that's also a really big play right now, in your opinion. We think lithium-ion batteries. We think phones exploding on planes. You say, no, that's not the case.
So when you look at lithium, the huge game changer here is electric vehicles. An electric vehicle uses about 10,000 times more lithium than a smartphone. So it really doesn't take that many electric vehicles on the road to just completely transform this commodity. And we're seeing that regulations around the world are really starting to line up to promote electric vehicles. China is going to make 10% of their cars by 2019 be electric vehicles. And that's a huge change in the market and a huge benefit for lithium miners.
Interesting topic. We'll have to have you back to talk more about it. Jay Jacobs, thanks for being here this morning. Thanks for getting up early.
Thank you.